Hi, I'm Jared with Fun Science Demos, and today we're in the gym because we're going to be launching some rockets. Previous videos, we showed you how to make our own version of a desktop stomp rocket using recycled plastics, and they fly great. We walked you through different ways to make different rockets and launchers, and they're a lot of fun to launch inside. Check it out. Now, all of these rockets flew differently, but we can't figure out which one flew the best until we start to measure things. We want to look at how high they go, how far they go, how long they stay in the air, and we can even look at how accurate they are. If we wanted to measure how long our rockets stay in the air, we could use a timer. Most phones have timers. We'd also need to slow that rocket down as it falls, and to do that, we designed and made these little flaps so that it falls like a little helicopter to slow down its fall. And you can change the size of those flaps. Do thicker flaps make it fall slower? Those are all things you'd have to redesign and measure to see which one could fall the slowest. Next, we could try measuring how high the rockets go or how far they fly. And to do that, we need to measure it with a meter stick or some kind of ruler or tape measure. But we could also try playing around with how long those rocket sizes are to see if it impacts how high they go and how far they go. Now, not only can we make rockets that are longer or shorter, we can also make rockets that are different weights, and we can weigh them using a scale. These two rockets look like they're the same length, but check out their weight. This rocket weighs in at 1.4 grams. Now, compare it to my pink rocket. They're about the same size. Let's check the weight. It comes in at 0.70 grams. It's almost half the weight of this blue rocket. We can compare how high that would fly or how far that would fly based on its weight. One of the last things we can test is accuracy. The design of the rocket launcher itself allows me to adjust the launch angle. And if I add fins, I can see if I can get my rocket to fly straighter. Now, a great way to measure accuracy is to have some fun with it and set up a target and see who can actually get closest to hitting the target. Let's give this one a try. Way long. So my last two launches overshot the target, so I have to adjust my angle, make it a little steeper, and let's see how we do here. Too steep, so I have to keep playing with that angle adjustment to see if I can get closer to the target. If you want to learn more about making your own version of a desktop stomp rocket using recycled plastics, check out our YouTube channel, Fun Science Demos. Science is so cool, especially when you get to launch something. Thanks for watching.